Hi guys, welcome to Sage Audio. Today we're going to be going over how to use the RX program to remove vocal clicks from your vocal performance. These clicks are things that just occur whenever a singer is performing, but if you leave them alone, they're just going to get worse over time, especially if you start using a lot of processing. So it's definitely something that you're going to want to take care of early on. This technique that I'm going to show you here is something that can save you a lot of time, especially if you were going to use, you know, equalization or gating to try to get rid of these clicks. It's not going to do it nearly as well as this technique will. So with that said, let's just get into it. But before we do, if this video or any of the other Sage Audio videos have been helpful for you, you can subscribe or click the link for notifications. Furthermore, if you have a mix that you're working on or one that you've already completed and you'd like to hear what it would sound like mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com for a free mastering sample of your work. First thing to do is to check under the module section. You got the D-click function right here, so just click on that. You have a few different options here. First one is random clicks versus periodic. I always do random, considering that the clicks that occur in a vocal performance are definitely not periodic. They're not, you know, like a metronome bleeding into the mic or anything like that. They kind of occur randomly, so definitely best to use the random click function. Under sensitivity, I don't typically set mine higher than about 3. I notice if I set it too high, then what occurs is too much is taken out of the performance, which can lead to phasing issues, which can lead to different artifacts that I don't want in the recording. So I try not to set it too high. But again, you can kind of mess with this and see what's best for you. I also got a frequency skew right here. I set mine a little bit towards the HF or the high frequency because the clicks that are occurring are typically of a higher frequency, so it only makes sense to me. Also, you got a preview section right here, which is going to allow you to listen to the recording with these clicks taken out of it. You also got a click section here, or a clicks only section, which is going to allow you to hear what's being taken out of the vocal performance. So let's preview it and just listen to what it sounds like without any clicks in it, or without that many clicks in it.
It's on me, yeah, yeah, and you try so damn hard.
So what you're going to notice is that you're not going to have too many vocal clicks in there, but if you just want to hear what's being taken out just so you can get a good idea of it, you can click this clicks only option and then preview it. And so what you might notice is that right here you have how many clicks that were being repaired or were being removed from the recording. It might have been a little bit hard to hear there, especially if you weren't using headphones, but you do have a lot of clicks that are being taken out of that small section. But whenever you get it to some settings that you really like, what you can do now is just process it. Make sure to unclick this clicks only function, because if you leave it clicked, then the file that's going to be bounced out is only clicks, which is pretty strange and pretty frustrating and definitely not what you want. So make sure to unclick that function and then click process. So while it's doing it, this is something that you're probably pretty familiar with. I'm sure all of you know how to process something and then how to export it. But one thing that's a little bit different about this RX program is that it changes the bit depth from 16-bit to 32-bit float. So one thing you're going to want to take care of is to make sure that you use dithering, otherwise you're going to be truncating the file. So whenever you're ready, just, you know, bounce it out and then import it back into your session. You're ready to go. But thank you so much for watching. I hope this has been helpful for you. And if this video or any of our other videos are something that you enjoy, subscribe or click the link for notifications. Furthermore, if you have a mix that you're working on or one that's already been completed and you'd like to hear what it would sound like mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com for a free mastering sample of your work.